hog the camera.
Yes, Mother.
And you, Mr. Collins, none of the Detroit sound today. You have something against Connie Francis?
Oh, the kids are just over the moon for rhythm and blues, though. They can't get enough.
Oh, they're kids, Corny. That's why we have to steer them in the right direction. I mean, you know what I mean.
Amber, I've got something for you. I figured since we've been going out sort of steadily, maybe we should make it official.
Oh, like your council member ring, how sweet! And it matches my hair color exactly!
None of that. Save your personal lives for the camera. And we're back in 5, 4, 3...
Now don't forget, guys and gidgets, our very first primetime spectacular is coming up on June 6th. We'll be live at Baltimore's brand new Eventorium, broadcasting nationwide. Telescouts will be on hand from all the major record labels, and sponsoring the event will be none other than our own Ultra Clutch Hairspray. So let's give a great big fawning Baltimore salute to the president of Ultra Clutch, Mr. Harriman F. Spritzer. Your choice for Miss Teenage Hairspray 1962.
My big break!
Well, isn't she a lovely, slim girl?
Well, I guess Amber's pretty, but she can't dance. Plastic little spasty. Oh my God, I'm gonna kill myself! Look! She's wearing Link Larkin's council ring. Hey, gang! Don't forget to watch Mom and Me next Thursday on Mother. Dog, it's your day! And I'm gonna be your Miss Teenage Hairspray. Remember, a vote for me from you is a vote for me!
What an unexpected ad-lib, Amber. And speaking of expecting the unexpected, our very own fun-loving, freewheeling Brenda will be taking a little leave of absence from the show. How long will you be gone, Brenda?
9 months!
So it seems we'll have an opening for a girl who's just as fun-loving, but maybe not quite as freewheeling. Hey, you want to be one of the nicest kids in town? Go to school tomorrow and head on down to Station WZZT to audition.
One day. No one is auditioning for anything. There'll be no cutting school in this house.
But this is her, Black.
Honey.
What?
Don't tell your mother she wants you.
Oh, she does?
Funny, honeys.
Stop, Wilbur. You're the funny one.
You're the funny one.
No, you. You are the funny one. Don't.
Daddy, tomorrow I'm auditioning to dance on a TV show.
You're going to have to go further than that to get around me, young lady. No one is auditioning for anything. And what did I tell you about that hair? I'll rat it up like a teenage kiss.
Mother, you are so 50s. Even our First Lady, Jackie B. Kennedy, rats her hair.
Yeah, well, you ain't. She's a hair hopper, that's what she is. And it got her put in detention again. Wilbur, talk to her. Girls like Tracy, people like us, you know what I'm saying. Wilbur, they don't put people like us on television. Is that to be laughed at?
I gotta take care of it. Tracy, this, TV thing, you really want it?
It's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it! This is America, babe. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not the problem, Wilbur!
When I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus, but I said, no, that's what you want. I got dreams of my own. I dreamt of opening my own chain of joke shops worldwide. Okay, so I still only got just one. But someday, if I can figure out how to keep the air from leaking out of my sofa-sized whoopee cushion, I'm going to make a noise heard around the world. Oh, you follow your dream, baby. I'm grabbing an orange crush and heading back down to the Hardy Car House.
I got my dream, and love it.
Famous? Learn how to get blood out of car upholstery. Now there's a skill you can take to the bank. You think I wanted to spend my life washing and ironing other people's clothing? No, I wanted to design them. Thought I'd be the biggest thing in brassieres. Well, be careful what you wish for. Now, start folding.
You from listening to race music? Oh, if the police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good.
Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. I am willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crap. But you have got to work with me. Now, let me let that sit.
Stop! There is no way to handle clean clothing. One day you'll own Edna's Occidental Laundry. Will you be ready?
I hope not.
Don't contradict me.
Don't disobey me.
Don't even think about going to that audition.
Please?
No.
Mother!
Stop.
Stop telling me what to do. Don't treat me like a child too.
Please.
I know that you want what's best.
Please.
But mother, please, give it a rest.
Stop.
Who would have guessed that Baltimore girls were also skags? My, how this town has gone downhill since I was crowned Miss Baltimore Crabs.
Phew, I thought we'd never get here. Stupid bus crash.
Not too late, dear. Just too much.
Tracy, look. It's Link. Link Larkin. So near and yet so gorgeous.
I know. Those girls were all over me. I don't know how Rock Hudson stands it. Excuse me, little darling. I hope I didn't dent you do.
And what are you doing here?
Well, I came to audition for Corny. Oh, my name is Tracy Turnblad, and like you, I go to Patterson Park High.
I've seen you.
Who could miss her?
Aren't you usually in detention about now?
Oh, well, I got school to come down here. Isn't that too cool? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just a little nervous. Can I start all over again? You all calm down right after I have a heart attack.
I can hear the bells.
Tracy, are you all right?
Well, don't you hear them chime?
I don't hear anything.
Can't you hear my heartbeat keeping perfect time? And
I'm Baltimore, it isn't.
Where's Corny? I'd love to dance for him.
I am the producer, and may I be frank? First impressions can be tough, but when I saw you, I knew it. If your size weren't enough, last answer just blew it. And so, my fears are short and stout. Never the answer is kicking you out. With your horn and your face, well, is it your fault? You're down with a case of this.
Dance.
council member, Miss Tracy Turnblad.
Oh, my word! Tracy, live in our own living room!
I think I've seen her here before.
And she's gonna be a regular!
Imagine, my little girl, regular at last!
Hi, Tracy! It's me! Teddy!
She can't hear you, hon. Hello? Yes, this is her childhood home! No, I'm not her father.
So let's all wave a wistful bye-bye to Brenda. We'll see you. Well, we'll see you next year. And to inaugurate our newest council member, Miss Tracy Turnblad, cozy up to old Corny and tell us about yourself, T-Rex.
I go to Patterson Park High, I watch your show, and I do absolutely nothing else.
And if you were president, what would your first official act be?
I'd make every day Negro Day.
Well, I read you like tomorrow's headlines. Hey, what do you say, kids? Looks like we might have a hot new candidate for Miss Teenage Hairspray.
No! She can't be Miss Hairspray. She's the before in the MetroCal diet ad. I'm the after. Afters always win.
Amber, what a comedian. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No! He can't! Because everyone knows that whenever he sings to me. He's completely involved with me! See?
Right. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
Would I? You people are ignoring the laws of nature!
Link Larkin, our very own budding Elvis, will now sing to the equally blooming Miss Tracy Turnblad this version of this week's Top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
A king ain't a king without the power behind the throne. chubby communist girl. Kissing on the mouth with possibly parted lips. I assure you, controversy is not what Ultra Clutch wishes to promote.
Negroes and chubby girls buy hairspray too, Mr. Spritzer.
Ms. Montes, how do you plan to handle this?
I plan to start by firing him.
You can't fire Corny Collins from the Corny Collins show.
Why not? They do it all the time on Lassie.
Mr. Spritzer, keep your audience. You gotta keep up with the times.
This show is fine the way it is.
Well, bringing Tracy on is just the beginning. I've got terrific ideas for updating the show.
I'm getting one of my sick headaches. Is there a place where I might lie down?
There's a bed in my office. So, you've got ideas, do you? I'm going behind my back to put this no-talent commie on the show as one of them.
You're damn right, Velma. It's time we put kids on the show that look like the kids that watch the show.
Not while I'm producing it.
Well, I was thinking it might be time to change that, too.
Are you threatening me, Collins?
Come on, Velma, you know me. But on the other hand, I could always take the show over to Channel 11.
Oh my God, that snake that sings. He's a puppet, but I hold the purse and the strings. God, a new Negro day would bring chaos and change. Now he's pushing this pinko who might give us all mange. She's a lettuce, a blackhead that must be expelled. The standard of beauty that must be upheld.
What am I wearing? House dress, stuffy, suppos? What are you wearing? Hello? Hello?
Mama, did you see me?
Of course I saw you. It was on television. I had to. The phone has been ringing like we was a telethon. To think a beloved TV icon, the fruit of my womb.
So, you're not mad?
Mad? How could I be mad? But, hon, if you'd only told me you was going to get on that show, I never would have said you couldn't. But, sit, tell me. Is fame everything you thought it would be? Are you happy, honey?
Yes, Mama. And I think I'm in love.
I know. I've been following. But you and I are going to have a talk about crooners. We can learn a lot from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds. There it goes again.
Hello? Yes, this is Tracy Turnbull. Hello, Mr. Pinky.
Mr. Pinky? The Mr. Pinky, as in Mr. Pinky's Husky Hideaway Quality Clothes, Hard Quality. Yeah, that Mr. Pinky!
You want to hire me as your exclusive spokesgirl in fashion equity? Ah! What's an effigy?
No clue, honey.
Our pleasure. We'll be right over, Mr. Pinky. Goodbye.
Agent? I don't know any agents. How about a nice bail bondsman?
Mother, put that thing down. I'm taking my new agent to the Hefty Hideaway and then out on the town.
Who? Me? Tracy Turnblad, fame has gone to your head and left you wacky. You need a top-shelf professional. Now, let's see. Who handled the DeBoer sisters? Well, who didn't?
Mama, there's a great big world out there I know nothing about. And when things get rough, a girl needs her mother.
And I'll be right there beside you, Mom, if that's what you want. And together we'll climb our way to the top. But can't we do it over the phone? I haven't left this apartment since Mamie Eisenhower rolled her hose and bombed her bangs.
Hey, Mama, look around. Everybody's moving to a brand new town.
anything, Amber, it was just a cool way to end the song.
Hey, look, here they come. Special Ed. Snicker, snicker, sneeze.
Knock it off, Bender. That ain't cool. Try to act like a grown-up.
Special Ed. Uh-oh.
Forces you to throw a ball at me today, seal it with a kiss.
You got a prayer for me too? This game can get pretty vicious.
What is scattered dodgeball anyway?
It's sort of like a protest rally. When the police show up, you'd better scatter and dodge.
Hi, Tracy! Hi! I'm sorry about your special ed-ness. But think of it as a testament to the record-breaking extremes your hair. So jealous.
Hello.
Seaweed, this is my best friend, Penny Lou Pingleton.
Wait a minute, I've seen you before at the gum machine. Getting your Wrigley.
I get 2 packs a day.
All that chewing must make the muscles in your mouth mighty strong.
Not really. Probably just average.
Safe up there for, you know, us. Don't worry, Cracker Boy. It's cool.
Lynn Larkin.
Always nice to see you, Miss Motormouth.
I'm Penny Lou Pinkleton, and I'm very pleased and scared to be here.
Well, you're welcome, kid, to come and sit here.
This is just so afro-tastic. Can I just say how thrilled I am to meet you? I'm Tracy Seaweed's friend.
Oh, yes, indeed. I've seen you, sweetie, all aglow on Corny's show.
Gee, thanks. But the only reason I'm even on the show is because of your son. Why can't we all dance together like this on television?
You think we haven't tried? We beg! We plead! We lie! We question the man! We question the girl! Who do we get?
One man!
Enough talk. We came here to dance.
Let's play some hide and seek.
Without dancers, they've got no
What a decision. Your girl's got vision.
We always tried to teach her to do what's right.
And give correct change.
Tracy, you can't do this. You're new to the council. You'll be blackballed and thrown off the show for sure.
That's why we're all going to do it together.
Not me.
You don't think segregation is wrong?
I like these people, but whether or not they're on TV won't get me a recording contract. That came out wrong. I've been singing and dancing and smiling on that show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my break. You've got everything. Brains, talent, personality. Me? I've got one chance to get seen nationwide. Tracy, Saturday night is everything I've worked for, and I'm not going to throw it all away. Come on, I'm leaving, and you got to go too.
No! I want to do this, and so should you. It's what's right. Link, stay. Please?
I'm sorry.
But you and me together, I was just starting to think...
Sure, me too. I don't know, things are getting too complicated. And there's still Amber. See you, little darling.
I'm sorry, Tracy. Oh, Mama. How could I think Link Larkin would ever care about someone like me?
Why wouldn't he? You're a beautiful girl. It's just Eddie Fisher all over again.
Mama, don't tease. I really liked him. I've never felt anything like this before.
I'm sure he likes you too, sweetie. It's just... boys are not the brightest of things. Still, you give him time. I'm sure he's going to figure out that he's crazy about you.
You have to say that. You're my mother.
I am more than your mother. I'm a woman in love. And we know about this stuff.
But Tracy, he could be right. Should you risk your career?
I never would have even gotten on the show if it weren't for seaweed. No. It's payback time!
That's my way.
I'm sorry. No one said anything about me appearing on television. I'm sorry. I simply cannot appear on television at my current weight.
You can't let weight restrict your fate. Look at me. I'm on TV.
Oh, but Miss Motormouth, you're a celebrity while I'm a simple housewife of indeterminate girth.
The bigger the girth, the more you work. Mr. Turnblad, you don't mind that the missus here is an Apple American now, do you?
Not at all. I think of her as prime real estate.
Yeah, nice and roomy. You listen to me. Big and stout. She said you gotta love.
my stomach's a little sour. I haven't had food in over an hour.
You just got a piece of my football mouse.
There's no food left in the dollhouse.
Oh, matron, yes. I have got to complain.
Casey Chandler, is
leaving here without my daughter.
It's okay, Daddy. They can't keep me in here forever. Besides, I've got a lot to think about. Might as well do it in solitary confinement.
I'm counting three. Then I'm rearresting you all for illegal trespass.
Let's go. We can't do Tracy any good here.
Touch one hair on my little girl's head and I'll be back to teach you a whole new meaning for split ends.
Keep the faith, baby.
Bam, heard the last from us.
You're so lucky to get out of the algebra final.
I'm all alone. My heart has grown, but it's broken too. This morning, life was a Baltimore fairy tale. Now I can't make bail. My mother's in shock. My father's in hock. I much prefer Link's arms to jailhouse cells. So Link, please rescue me now, 'cause I love you and this prison smells. Link, hear the bells. Get ready, Baltimore. There's a bright brand new day in store. Let me out so the streams are flow. I'll eat some breakfast then.
One day I wandered beyond the boundaries of the largest McCall's pack. But I always dreamed that one day I'd put out my own line of queen-size dress patterns.
You were good, Edna.
Where's it gotten me? 20 years later, I'm still washing and mending and ironing everybody else's clothing.
But one day, Edna...
No, no, no day, Wilbur. My time is come and gone. I'm like a half-filled book of green stamps. Beyond redemption.
Wilbur. Suddenly I feel so old.
Oh, nonsense, doll. You're spry as a slinky. Whenever I'm near you, it's like grabbing hold of a giant joy bus.
Styles keep a-changing, the world's rearranging. But Edna, you're timeless to me.
Hemlines are shorter, a beer costs a quarter.
But time cannot take what comes free.
You're like a stinky old cheese, babe.
What?
Just getting riper with age. And you're like a fan of the seas, babe.
All right.
But there's no cure, so let this fever rage. Some folks stand it, say time is abandoned. But I take the opposite view. Cause when I need a lift, time brings a gift.
Timeless to me. Head is a higher, mic feels like barbed wire, but you stay as chic as can be. You're like a hermitage ripoff, a vintage they'll never forget. So pour me a teeny weeny ripoff, and we can toast the fact we ain't dead yet. I can't stop eating.
Shabbat Shalom.
You're timeless to me. You're timeless to me.
Funny, you don't look Jewish.
You're timeless to me.
Well, you can't always tell.
Sure you can.
Station, I overheard Mrs. Von Tussle talking to Spritzer. Tracy, it's Amber. The talent scouts are coming to see. It had nothing to do with me. All this time, I thought Amber and I were a team. She and her mother were just using me to make her look popular. I feel like such an idiot.
That makes two of us.
I know a palooka like me isn't worthy of a groundbreaking extremist like you. It's a little scuffed from an Amber food in my face when I told him I'd rather be with you.
You did?
I did. So would you consider wearing my ring?
Would I? Would I?
To lose thee would lose myself. Some kid named Milton wrote that in the third floor boys' room.
It's beautiful. I have a good life. Great parents, my own room, stacks of 45s, three sweaters, plus a learner's permit good through August. But you know what I've been missing? Link.
I think I do. Ow. Oh, Trace, they can keep us from kissing, but they can't stop us from singing. Once I was a selfish fool who never understood. I never looked inside myself. On the outside, I looked good. When we met and you made me the man I am today. Tracy, I'm in love with you. No matter what you wear, without love. Life is like the season with no summer. Without love, life is rock and roll without a drum. Tracy, I'll be yours forever.
kill. In entertainment news, Eva Marie is no saint.
Lord have pity, it's a crazy scene. Who's at the back door? It's my baby. Aunt Penny, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Stevie's got a girlfriend.
Is it okay I brought her home? I had to get away from my nasty-ass mama.
Hush now, don't explain. I got an England and a twinkling. First time I seen you two dancing together.
And you don't mind?
I never mind, love. It's a gift from above. But not everyone remembers that. So you two better brace yourself for a whole lot of ugly coming at you from a never-ending parade of students.
Well, that's okay. My mother's gonna kill me anyway. No, she won't! She'll kill him!
Miss Mortimer, we brought Tracy out of jail.
We know. It's been on all three channels.
The jailbreak was easy compared to getting a cab to take us to this side of town.
We all gotta get busy. Only 24 hours before Miss Hairspray, and it's gonna be on national TV. We may never get another chance like this, but this time I'm gonna start by getting Corny and the guards at the studio to help us.
Oh, maybe your dad could help. He sometimes has ideas.
Yeah, and I know a guy
who... No, I've gotta turn myself in and go back to jail.
Say what?
Tracy, no.
I can't put all of you in any more danger. We should have thought more before we broke out. My dad could lose the Hardy Har Hux, and Link, you could go to prison for what you did tonight.
Just first base in the back of the cab, I swear.
We already tried. It didn't work.
It won't be like Mother-Daughter Day. Mrs. Von Tessel said there'd be armed guards surrounding the Eventorium. With arms! Someone could get shot.
And for what? Just so we can dance on some old fish, huh?
Oh, nobody ever said this was going to be easy. If something is worth having, it's worth fighting for.
Tracy, why did you start this in the first place? Was it just the dance on TV?
No.
Was it so you could get the boy?
No, I almost lost him because of it.
Maybe it was just to get yourself famous.
No, I just think it's stupid. We can't all dance together.
So you tried once and you failed. We can't get lazy when things get crazy. Children, you're not the first to try, and you won't be the last. But I'm here to tell you that I'm going to keep lining up until someday somebody breaks through. And I've been looking at that door much longer than you.
What door?
The front door. There's light in the darkness, though the night is black.
There's a cry in the distance.
You! Arms! Riot squad! I want everybody out of the lobby and up here, pronto! Ha! What is this thing? Some kind of Trojan horse? Oh, of course. And what's inside? Your jailbird daughter?
Not a chance.
Well, if she's hiding in that can, she will rot in that can. Guards, if anyone so much as touches that thing, open fire!
Understood, ma'am.
You win this time, Von Tussle. You're one clever woman, I'll say that much.
Get out! And we're coming back to Corley on camera one. In three, two...
And now for the talent portion of our competition, where the front-runner gals present a dance of their own creation. Ooh. Presently, it appears Amber Von Tussle and Tracy Turnblad are neck and neck. But, since according to the latest police bulletins, Miss Turnblad is still at large...
And very large!
Our Miss Teenage Hairspray might just be a foregone conclusion. Still, our rules say the contestant has to dance for it. Are you ready, Amber?
Ready for real life!
Yeah.
Me?
Of course you, Link. Oh, but I'd also like a graduate degree in musicology, plus a minor in ethnic studies. Oh, and there's something else I'd like to say. The Courtney College Show is now and forevermore officially integrated!
America, look up. Here is history right before your eyes. Television will never be the same.
This is marvelous! The phones are going crazy. The whole country's watching. Even the governor called. He's enjoying the show so much that he's granted a pardon to Tracy. Plus a full scholarship to Essex Community College! You cannot buy this kind of publicity. Bella!
Yes, sir.
You're a genius.
I am? Yes, I am.
Ultraclutch is about to launch an entirely new line of products, and I want this woman to head the campaign.
I just don't know what to say.
It comes with offices, company car, multi-figure salary.
I just don't know what to say.
Bella Lamont Dunham! You are the newly appointed vice president of Ultra Glow. Beauty products for women of color.
I just don't know what to say.
And now America would like to hear you two kids sing our new theme song. I think I can get you a recording contract.
My big break!
Penny! Penny, sweetie, where are you?
Excuse me. Pardon, excuse me.
Penny, honey, mommy's here. Show yourself.
Excuse me. Pardon me.
Sweetie, honey, where are you?
Whoa! Sir!
Really?
Just may bust a gut.
Well, we wouldn't want you to hurt yourself now, would we?
That's my girl!
Hey, wait a minute! Before I get completely sick, would somebody tell me this? If she came in through the front door, what the hell is in that can?
My masterpiece. Seaweed, did you give me a hand?
Come right up, Mr. T.
This could be the largest novelty item ever erected.
a little bit more of your time. We're going to roll the band back out, lock the doors, and start the sucker again. Right now, theaters all across the Broadway community are collecting for a marvelous organization called Broadway Cares Equity Fight Days. They help many other charities, which I will pull out right now, and I just don't want to get them wrong. The AIDS Initiative for People Living with AIDS and HIV, both here and around the world. The Phyllis Newman Women's Health Initiative, dealing with women's health issues. And the Al Hirschfeld Free Health Clinic, which comes in really handy if you get a bad case of the clap. Anyway. So last year, over $6 million was raised for this incredible organization, and they are amazing. And so tonight, you're going to have an opportunity to help out, too. So, Nikki, what have we got to show these folks?
Well, we have some fun stuff for you guys to take home if you're interested in donating for Groovy Things. So here we have a lovely hairspray poster signed by the entire cast and held by the lovely and charming Link. Here for a smaller donation, we have our hairspray pins. They are a $5 item, and they're groovy to stick on your coat jacket. You can brag to them, all your friends.
Yeah, they are nice. Yeah,
and a keychain, too. You put that on your keys as opposed to your jacket. And here, Kevin, would you do the honors and model our lovely ultra plush?
Why not? Thank you very much. Oh, Kevin, I can't imagine you can't want anything to center stage. Some of the cast members are gone, and they've got buckets by the door. And on your way out, if you have spare change or whatever, you're dropping those buckets. You know, there's 1,500 people here. One person, if every person gave $1, that'd be $1,500 we'd raise tonight. We want to thank you for your generosity. Thank you for coming to Hairspray. Now get the hell.